And so when you see in the press about the billions that people make by cheating the people, there is a certain sense of anger, a certain sense of frustration, certainly. And how do we really get to the grips? How can we stop them? Do we need to prosecute somebody and put that person in jail to send a powerful message?
Yeah, again, we have to think about the political will. If political will is not there, because now they have mixed up everything, because keeping people in happy and develop a country is a two different scenario.
Right.
So first we have to keep people happy.
Yeah.
So that completely avoided area. And they are trying to develop the country by building buildings and all those things, right? So because that is the area to get that easily get the commission and bring their pocket full.
Right.
So that all most of expenditure they transfer into getting that big infrastructure development and building buildings and all those things. So but people are suffering, and the same time if you need to keep people happy,
yeah.
So only thing is we have to give them for a fair price for their product. So then half of the people can live happily in the village side, no?
Mm-hmm.
So, but nobody's think about that, and everybody's trying to build huge infrastructure, huge building and things like that, because that is the easiest way to bring money out of this. As I know very well, the last 2-3 years we have issued a special report, more than 40 special report. Out of those 40 report, there are billions of rupees we have shown that corruption taken place.
Mm.
Especially rice import case, total loss is 15 billion. And the coal case, coal company import is another billion. And the livestock import from Australia, another more than, I suppose, 8 billion or something. So nobody's care about that, those billions, no? So if you bring those money back to the country, so all those people can keep happily.
Mm.
But who is care about that? Nobody's care about that, no?